just want to have a look at Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The problem is that we are all sinners. Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So this is the situation we've got here. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Just in relation to death, look at Revelation 21:8, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers, that is fornicators and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars, shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. And in relation to the gift of God, Ephesians 2:8 and 9, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. That is, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. In other words, we cannot work our way to heaven. We've got to come God's way, and the work has been done by the Lord Jesus Christ when he died upon that place called Calvary. Yes, Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures. He was buried, and he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. He shed his precious blood that your sins might be washed away. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. John 11:26, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me, the Lord Jesus Christ could say, shall never die. Believest thou this? That has never suffered eternal punishment in the lake of fire. John 5:24, verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation or judgment, but is passed from death unto life. You see, you and I are dead in our trespasses and in our sins. God wants to make us alive in the Lord Jesus Christ. See, he that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, and yet God will have all men to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. I wonder, what have you done with the Lord Jesus Christ? That will determine where you'll be in eternity. If you receive him as your own personal Savior by repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ, you receive him, you'll have your sins forgiven, live forever in heaven. Or, if you reject or neglect the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no other way of salvation. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Wonder, are you saved? If you don't get saved, you'll go to that place called the lake of fire, where there's weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth, eternal burnings. Who among us shall dwell with the everlasting burnings? We need to ask ourselves that question. You need to flee from the wrath to come. God is angry with the wicked every day, and yet he desires your salvation. He wants you to be saved. He wants you to be in heaven with himself forever. The only way that can take place is by repentance toward God. That is, change your mind, agree with God that you're a sinner, and then faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. He must be born again into God's family through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures. He was buried, and he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Your sins can be washed away in the precious blood of Christ, through faith in him, repentance and faith in the Lord Jesus Christ.